How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to LevelM.cast, bringing you Real Working Rig Ashkins for 2023. Very, very happy to see that the Real Working Rig line continues into 2023. One of the absolute favorite staples here on the channel. Personal collector here. You know, we love Real Working Rigs. Definitely one of the best things Matchbox has ever made, in my opinion. I think a lot of people can agree with that. These are the four models in the mix. It'll be just like previous years. There'll be four mixes of four models, technically. Usually there's four mixes. 16 models for the year. These two on the left are going to be reissues. The two on the right are brand new decos, so we'll just go ahead and start with the first one. This is our first reissue. This is the International Workstar Street Sweeper. This was a brand new casting, potentially last year, I think, or maybe the year before, but we've only seen it in one deco, and that's the deco. There is the deets on the back, should you want the deets. This is the original version of this exact one right here. You can see this one's dated M47. So I'm pretty sure there's not going to be any differences between the two. But as you know, as is the custom, we will do some comparos. So this does have a number of moving features. The little, you know, street sweeper part here is kind of sort of separate. It doesn't move, but this part of the back moves a little bit. It's just kind of an extra piece there. This does dump like you'd expect. And then on the very back, it does have an opening little hatch part for the dump. So it's a good looking street sweeper. It's got some good details to it, but it's unfortunate that we can't get a new deco just right out the gate. So the one on the top will be our original. So taking a look at the two, you can see right away the Street Services logo, which is right here, is printed differently. Let's see if it's the same on the other side. So it looks like there's just a lot of differences in the paint and the paint colors, but there is a lot of difference to those logos for sure. Not just thick painted. It's actually a different setup for sure. Looking through the rest of it, you'll see that this is a lot darker green than on this one up here. This is the original on the top. Other than that, I mean, it's the same print. That's just, you know, the details are going to be a little bit different. Quality of prints, that's just the way it works. You'll see that the shield on the door looks a lot closer to each other versus on the dump section in the back. But the greens are exact. They do have the same wheels, same color. Foil print on them, all the accessories, base colors, all that kind of stuff is the same. Taking a look at the front prints, the grill print on the original on the top is much, much thicker than the new one on the bottom. Orange is much, much darker than the new one on the bottom as well. So a number of changes there. As far as windows go, they are the same tint. So sweep these guys around. The original is on the right-hand side, so a little backwards right now. Take a look at our base deets, see if there's any differences between the two. You see our date codes buried in there. R36, so this is Real Working Rig number 43. There are no other differences between that. Bases are the same, so that's a little bit unfortunate. So I didn't expect there to be anything different with these ones. I was hoping there'd be some different, but unfortunately not. By the way, that was number 4 of 16, so forgot to mention that. All right, number 2 of 16, this is the Western Star 6900 XD Wrecker. This is also a reissued deco. Yes, that is for Chuck. Chuck is a former Matchbox ambassador. If you've ever been to the gathering, I'm sure you've met him. He's a very, very, very nice guy. I've met him a bunch of times. This is the original version of that tow truck. This one is dated M32. This one does not have you know, fanciness with it, I guess you could say. Some of the tow trucks kind of have some better details, I guess. I really like the deco on this one. I think it looks pretty good. So we'll crack this one open. There is our tow truck. Of course, this does have, you know, this tow apparatus to slide back and forth, pull the hook out and pull down the axle bar. And then, of course, you can push this back in. And then it's designed so that when you have a vehicle on it, you can push that and actually lifts them up and sort of kind of locks into place. So pretty cool feature. Of course, it does lift up. It's not a rotator, so it doesn't rotate. But other than that, looks pretty good. This one dated R32. So very interesting. We go from M32 to R32. So taking a look at our bases with the original on the top. There's not going to be any base changes to these, as you can see. All the same print, all the same details, all the same information. We'll put our original on the top. And we'll take a look at this. Kind of difficult to hold these. I do apologize. So take a look at the side. It is the same tampos on both. I can tell you right now that the tampo on the original, which is on the top, the tampo on the door is a little bit smaller than the tampo on the new one, which is on the bottom. Definitely a bit of a different font. So you can see there's a little bit of difference there. Other than that, they are relatively close. The two-tone blues are different. So you see this much lighter blue versus the original, which had a much darker blue. But they still both have the silver detail in there. But those blues are significantly different between the two. They both still have their headlights printed up. They both still have chrome grille, chrome stacks, chrome steps on the side, which is pretty nice. Definitely a little bit of an upscale detail. Same detail on this side as well. Again, just the blues are different. So very nice. I will take that. I always like when there's enough difference. But we don't have to worry about for that for the next two, because these are brand spanking new decos. This was a brand spanking new casting in 2021. We got a recolor in 2022, and now this is our third color, number 3 of 16. This is the Garbage King XL, the front-loading garbage truck. Yes, it does come with a garbage can, which is very nice. At first, I was like, why the color differences? You know, you have green, you have white, you have orange, but this looks good. Looks pretty good. Lots of nice print on the side. It says Garbage King XL on there. Really like the print right there for the fire use. That looks pretty good. A little bit of gold off of there. Very, very nice. Very nice. Very nice looking. This guy, obviously, real working rig, so he does have a garbage can, which is completely separate. If you guys have ever picked up the Garbage Scout from the mainline, the two garbage cans do not go together. They are two completely different ones. So unfortunately, they missed the bit on that, but of course it does dump up and then right into the top, just like it should. Bring it down, drop it off, and then of course when you're done and load it up, it does tilt. And then of course the back opens up so you can dump it all out. So that's a pretty good feature. Does everything you'd expect from a tow or a garbage truck, and of course these do fold up as well. So you can't be driving around with those down. Definitely not a good thing. So taking a look at the deets on the back. Real working rig number 51. Use caution, stay clear of door. Recycling is everybody's responsibility. A little bit of reflectives on the side there. Looks pretty good. A little bit of detail behind the cab. Some kind of initials for something or some sort. Taking a look at the base deets. Nothing fancy on the base. Same old, same old. Of course, real working rig number 51. It is the 51st real working rig casting is what that means. All right, moving on to the last one, which is definitely going to be the best one. And yes, this is the first time, believe it or not, that we are seeing a National Parks, a legit National Parks livery in real working rigs. And I think this is a perfect fit. Number 1 of 16, this is the MBX excavator. And yes, it is. Does everything you want it to do, because of course it's an excavator. Now it's funny because so this is packaged in the package like this. They used to package it in there like this, and I hated that because that's not the way it's supposed to go. There's a counterbalance on the back of it. That's the whole purpose of why it hangs off the back. It always just bothered me that they packaged it that way, but this one is packaged correctly, so very, very nice. Of course, the scoop does move in. It is hinged, so there is some click in it. Although it's a soft click, you don't hear the click, but it'll hold it. And then, of course, those pistons actually move. Each arm moves fully, and then, of course, it does rotate full 360, just like you'd expect. And then, of course, last but not least, it does have full real working rubber tracks. I do tell everybody to rotate those every once in a while. Flip this guy around the correct way. There is the base deets, R36, excavator V1700. I'm not really sure what the V1700 is, but it's always been on there. As far as the deco, there you go. National Parks Service pack there. Does have the seal on there in orange. Looks very, very good. It says unit number 5. Legitimate National Parks. Legit. Even has extra tampo on the top. This is the Forestry Division. This is why it's such a good fit to have this on the excavator. Definitely something you would see in the national parks for sure. It says US 403. This is really, really good. I mean, this is really, really good. I actually bought a couple extra ones of these, to be honest with you, because it's just that good. It's just that good. So that one is perfect too. And of course, it has the greatest stance ever when you're just sitting there perfectly nice and ready to go, making some noise on that aspect. So there you go. That is the AKs for 2023 Matchbox Real Working Rigs. Not too happy that we already have two reissues, but this one's a little frustrating because that one easily could have had a new deco on it. That would have looked actually really, really good in Rannick, just saying. It's my opinion. But other than that, these two in the back, absolutely primo, absolutely fantastic. Either way, I will take all Real Working Rigs I can get my hands on. So Matchbox, keep them coming. And just like us here at Bubble M, we're going to keep videos coming. So we're going to roll out and get to the next one. Peace.